If someone asks you what is the difference between finalized and disposed method in an interview, start saying like that. Both methods perform cleanup of unmanaged resources. The difference is finalized method cleanup is undeterministic, whereas disposed method cleanup is deterministic. And what does that mean? Let's get into the details. Finalize is like destructor method of a class. So finalized method are called when garbage collection happens. So you have to understand a little bit about garbage collection to understand the finalized method. How the memory cleanup happens for managed resources. If you declare a variable, how the memory is claimed by .NET framework. In C++, when you declare a variable, you have to allocate memory, use it, and then deallocate the memory. So it becomes very difficult. In .NET framework, it takes care of memory management for you. If you are using some variable, it will do the cleanup for yourself. So how the .NET garbage collection works, it has its own routines to clean up. If your system is under stress, there are certain conditions, there are certain flags when the garbage collection happens. So you don't know when the garbage collection happens. If you are using some unmanaged resources like file, stream, database connection, .NET framework doesn't clean these unmanaged resources. So if you are cleaning up in the finalized method, you never know when that connection is getting released. So if you are done with some database operation, you want to release database connection back to the pool so that your application scalability is better. You can force the garbage collection, but it's not recommended by Microsoft. You should not be calling garbage collection method by force. Another drawback of finalize it, you don't know which order the finalize bit happen. When one method finalize may be called, when another method finalize may be called. Another thing is, most of the finalize object are put in a queue. So you have three methods whose finalize method need to be called to release some unmanaged resources. They are put in the queue. If some exception happened in first object, the second and third finalize method of second and third will never call. So you can see there are a lot of issues with the finalize cleanup. I have never used finalize method for my cleanup in my whole career. So finalize method is not good if you have to release unmanaged resources like file handler, memory stream, database connection, then how you do it? So here comes the iDisposable pattern. In disposable pattern, there's a iDisposable interface. You inherit this iDisposable interface and override the dispose method. That way, when the method when you call a close call, or you can call the dispose method in your program to release these. If you are reading some file in some file reader, you can release this file lock once you are done using the dispose pattern. One good practice is you should code, if you are overriding dispose method, implementing dispose pattern, it can be called multiple times, and you have to make sure if you have released the connection in dispose, second time it's called, it should not try to release which object which has been already released, which is no longer in the memory. So once you have implemented dispose method, there are two ways of calling. First thing is, you can in C#, there's a very good using command. So if you use this variable, it makes sure that your object is disposed, it's released if you are doing some cleanup. Another way is most of the time I try using, and the other way is try catch finally. If you know that there's a syntax, you can you put your code in try block. In some exception happens, you catch it, and finally is the way where you release all the objects. So whether there's some exception happens in the error handler, finalize code is always called. So there you can call your dispose method to release some valuable resources. So thanks, friend. Today we discussed what is the difference between finalize and dispose methods in C#. If you like this video, like it, share it, and subscribe to my channel for your regular updates. Also, connect with me on LinkedIn and Twitter, especially LinkedIn, if you like small summaries of the video. I will be posting a lot of the small summaries of the video on LinkedIn. Thanks again.